Hello everyone. So you've got your Raspberry Pi and it's the brains of your next big project. But what if you need to know exactly where you are in the world?
And we don't just mean in the right neighborhood. We're talking about centimeter level RTK high precision accuracy, the kind you might need for an autonomous lawnmower, land surveying tools, or high speed robotics projects.
That's exactly what the SparkFun GNSS Flex FAT is for. It's the key that unlocks our entire powerful ecosystem of SparkPNT GNSS Flex modules for your Raspberry Pi.
But we know that getting from this module to this and all the way to a high precision fix can look a little intimidating.
And that's exactly why we're here today. We're going to walk you through every step to get you set up and connect your Raspberry Pi to your GNSS FlexFAT and module.
We'll cover the complete physical assembly and then dive into software, including configuring your Raspberry Pi serial ports, installing the right tools, and communicating with your module.
By the end of this video, you'll have a fully operational, high-precision GNSS system ready for your Raspberry Pi. My name is Chris.
And I'm Lauren. Let's get started. So to do this whole project, what you're going to need is a Raspberry Pi, the SparkFun GNSS Flex pHAT, a GNSS Flex module. Today we're using the LG290P, but this setup process is pretty similar across the board with the exception of the Mosaic X5. There's a few extra steps for that one. You're going to need a U.FL cable, a set of headers, a computer mouse, a keyboard, and a monitor.
Because the GNSS Flex system is completely modular, we connect all the boards via headers, no soldering required. We're going to be starting from the top down by attaching the module to the FAT. If you're confused on which way the module should be oriented, there's these little white silkscreen marks on both the FAT and the module. That way you'll know you're connecting it the right way. Next up, we're going to be attaching the U.FL to both the FAT and the module. Next up is the headers. Simply attach the extra long ones to the Raspberry Pi, and then stack the FAT on top of the Raspberry Pi. Next up, we're going to attach the peripherals, including the mouse, keyboard, monitor, but the external antenna will come at the end. After hardware setup, we're going to need to start downloading the Raspberry Pi OS onto a microSD card. We're just downloading the Raspberry Pi OS and not the Raspberry Pi OS full. It won't hurt if you download the full, but for today's purposes, we only need the OS. You will want to make sure that you also have a Raspberry Pi imager downloaded and installed. We already have that covered. We're going to select a Raspberry Pi 5, since that's what we're using. We're going to select the normal Raspberry Pi OS 64-bit. And we're going to be selecting our microSD card. We are not going to be applying any customization settings. And yes, keep in mind that if you have anything on this microSD card, it will be deleted. This process can take up to a couple minutes, so just be patient. Once the OS has been written to the SD card, you can now safely remove the card from the reader.
So we're just going to put the microSD card with the OS on it into the Raspberry Pi. All right, so now it's time to start configuring the Raspberry Pi. So we're starting from scratch here, so we have to set up a bunch of settings so that it can use all the serial ports and everything that we need to communicate with the Flex module. So we currently are in the United States. We're using American English. We are in the Denver time zone. Hey, hey. And we're going to use the US keyboard and the English language. Now we have to connect to the Wi-Fi. Next, they want us to pick a browser, so we're just going to go along with the default. And then they want us to update the software, so I'm going to allow them to update anything we need. It should be fine because we just downloaded this OS, so there shouldn't be anything that's out of date. Your Raspberry Pi is now set up and ready to go. Yay! Press launch to launch the desktop. I'm going to do that. Now it's launching, so we have to wait again. Look at that! So now we have to go through some steps to configure all the settings to make sure we can fully communicate with our other hardware. So the first thing to do is to update software. We just did that. You can run a terminal command for it if you so desire. So what we have to do is we have to go into some configuration settings and move some stuff around and add a few lines so that we're able to communicate with all of the serial ports we need to. So there's a few additional ports we have to enable. So in order to do that, we have to edit our config.txt file that's in our boot firmware directory. So how we do that is we run this command, sudo nano slash boot slash firmware slash config.txt. And what this is going to do is bring up the config text file. So there's a few things we have to do here. We have to go all the way to the end of the file. And we have to add a few lines. So DT overlay equals UART2. DT overlay equals UART3. And then we're going to do it again for UART4. And then we're going to write out the file. So that's saving it in the same spot it was saved before in the directory. And then we are going to exit. So now what we want to do is we want to reboot with our new settings. So we do that by typing sudo reboot, not rebot, reboot. And there we go. We're starting over. So we've just rebooted, and we're going to open up another terminal window because we still have some more configuration stuff to do. So we need to add privileges for our username in order to access the serial port. This is the case for most Linux computers. So in order to do that, go sudo add user my username. And then group name. So there are two groups that we can add ourselves to. One of them is called TTY. The other one is dial out. So I'm going to do TTY for this one. Boom. It added me. I'm going to do the same thing for dial out just in case. It says and or in the instructions. You can do both. One or the other should be fine. Okay. So it says I'm already a member. So by joining TTY, I joined both of those. So the Python package that we have to use for the GNSS Flex system is called piGPSClient. So in order to do that, we have to create a Python virtual environment in our Raspberry Pi and install piGPSClient inside of that. So the first thing we're going to do is create our virtual environment. So first, I'm just going to check our Python version to make sure that it's installed. So we have 3.13.5, so we should be fine. So I'm going to make our virtual environment, Python 3-m, then nothing exciting. Test. Okay, so I've created this virtual environment. So now what we're going to do is we're going to activate it. So the way that we do that, source, and then we do the name of our virtual environment, which is test, slash, bin, slash, activate. So the reason we do this is because now we're inside of basically this entirely new computer environment inside of this directory called test. So anything we install here, anything we edit here is not going to change anything on our larger operating system, which is why this is used in software a lot. So if we mess with our Python installation, if we do anything crazy in this virtual environment, nothing is going to change outside of it. So now we have to install piGPSClient. We're going to do that using pip. And first, I'm going to check that we have pip installed. And we do. So that's cool. All right. So we're going to go pip 3, install piGPSClient. And now we just have to run it. So we're in the virtual environment already because that's where we installed it. So we just have to write piGPSClient. And there is our window. So the only thing we have left to do is take our whole setup somewhere with a good view of the sky. So right now we're in the middle of our building. It's not going to work. But we're going to go connect to an antenna, get next to a window, and see what kind of data we get. We have our antenna connected. And we have our piGPSClient window up. So the only thing we have to do is select our port TTYAMA0. And then here we're going to up our rate to 460,800. Refresh that and then hit this. And then we can start getting our data. So now we are in the SparkFun break room. And we've got Chris hanging out the window with an antenna on a pole. He's doing great work. And here we're getting all of our data coming in. So this window down here is telling us how many satellites we have and from which constellation they are. This is all of our raw data right here. Down over here, it's giving us a position fix. So you can see we're right there by the Rocky Mountains. And then over here, it's giving us our latitude, longitude, resolution. So from here, you can log data, you can export it, you can kind of do whatever you want with it. And there's a bunch of different views and map views that you can use.
As you can see with GNSS Flex and Raspberry Pi, setup is easy and straightforward. And the best part is, because of this modular system, you get to choose which Raspberry Pi you use and which receiver you use.
You can browse all the different modules and the pHATs on our website. Have fun.
Hello, everyone. I should be looking at the...
Look up here.
Yeah. Because the GNSS Flex system is completely completely, there is flame train, plane train, coal train to get you set up and connected. We had a bingo of trains.